On the question of racial discrimination, the Addis Ababa conference taught to those who will learn this further lesson that until the philosophy that holds one race superior and another inferior is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned, until there are no longer first-class or second-class citizens of any nature, that until the color of a man's skin is of no more significance than the color of his eyes, that until the basic human rights are equally guaranteed to all without regard to race, that until that day, the dream of lasting peace, world citizenship, and the rule of international morality would remain but a fleeting illusion to be pursued, but never obtained. Shalom, I, Alonkone Teferi, will address an urgent message to the House of Israel. And just to clarify, if anyone has any doubts who the House of Israel is, well, it is and belongs correctly and truthfully to the Afro-Shemitic peoples of the world. But let I remind those people that it is not, as His Majesty clearly taught, it is not limited only and to and for them. But those two, as were the phrases of the covenant, are only words. The value depends wholly on our will to observe and honor them and give them content and meaning. His Imperial Majesty, October 7th, 1963, New York, addressing the United Nations. Now, it's noteworthy is a study in Levitical law. And you will come to learn that it was not the blood inside the veins of the sacrifice, but rather the blood that was spilled upon the altar, from which I can grow and build. Now, let us go to scripture. Open your Bible's New Testament, the Gospel of Matthew, Ye Mateos Wengeo, chapter 14, yes, and verse 22. I'm not going to go in full detail. Those seeking a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. Now, and straightway Jesus constrained his disciples to get into a ship. He demanded that he ordered for them to get into a certain ship and to go before him to the other side while he sent the multitudes away. And when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. Now, His Majesty and Jesus, they went up into a higher height to pray alone, holy, separate. You see, Jesus dwelt among his disciples, but he never committed fully because he knew what was in man. Now, but the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. Are we being tossed with waves? Is it that we might not be getting anywhere because the doctrine is contrary to the spirit, that which we are to seek truthfully and faithfully and diligently? Now, and in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "Is it a spirit?" And they cried out for fear. But straightway Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid, it is I am a man," says His Majesty, correct? Now, when we see Jesus walking on water, let's not get scared. Rather, let us seek His way, and to we shall do. Now, let us go to the Gospel of Mark. Chapter 6. Verse 47. And when even was come, the ship was in the midst of the sea, and he alone on the land. Note, Jesus alone was in the land on good ground, firmly established. And here we are in the sea. Now, and he saw them toiling and rowing, for the wind was contrary to them. Is that not what's going on? Are we trying to get the ball rolling? Or are we toiling to row and we are getting nowhere? Well, maybe we're taking on contrary winds. Now, and about the fourth watch of the night, he cometh to them, walking upon the sea, and would have passed by them. But when they saw him walking on the sea, they supposed it had been a spirit and cried out. It almost, Jesus Christus almost passed us by, like a fleeting illusion in which we are in pursuit, but will never obtain until that philosophy. Let Jesus pass by. Let's find out why. Oh, one second, please. Okay, I'm going to start from verse 50. For they all saw him and were troubled, and immediately he talked with them and said to them, be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid. And he went up to them into the ship, and the wind ceased, and they were sore amazed in themselves beyond measure, and wondered. As soon as Jesus boards Ionai vessel, the winds ceased. Let's focus on receiving Christ and the toiling of rowing up against contrary winds will cease instantly. Now let us go to the Gospel of John, chapter 6, verse 15. And verse 15 it reads, when Jesus therefore perceived that they would come and take him by force to make him a king, he departed again into a mountain himself alone. Now, don't, you know, take it how you wish, but there's some that seek to claim ownership and dominion over his majesty. And they, you know, it seems overzealously, I guess in they seek ignorance, basically. Well, like if his majesty belonged to some group of people. As for I, my opinion, I can speak for I. You can have him. We'll see what he thinks about that. But as for me, I'm his. So whatever he chooses to do with I, so be it. I don't care. As long as it be his will. And so I say that because so that some of us not get into this contrary wind, trying to claim his majesty and Jesus for themselves, very greedily, very wrongfully. Now, I understand from my studies that I am only a tool to serve his purpose, so be it, you know? But I've never come across any information that leads I to overstand that somehow he's, you know, like some Christians will say, like, my Jesus, or, you know, he's our emperor. Well, you know, you take that up on him. Now, I'll continue. And because I forgot where I'm at, I'm just going to start from verse. Okay, verse 16 I left off. I apologize for that. And when even was come, his disciples went down to the sea. So Jesus goes up to a higher height, to the mountains, to pray alone. He's the only one on land. And we go down to the sea. Verse 17. And entered into a ship. And when and went over the sea toward Capernaum. And it was now dark, and Jesus was not come to them. And the sea arose by reason of a great wind that blew. Are we flooding? Well, so when they had rowed about 5 and 20 or 30 furlongs, they see Jesus walking on the sea and drawing nigh to the ship. And they were afraid, but he said to them, "It is I, be not afraid." Then they willingly received him into the ships, and immediately the ship was at the land whither they went. Now, as soon as we accept Jesus Christ within I, we automatically get to the Father via him. And all troubles will just immediately cease. Any contrary wind, any difficulty we might be confronted with will cease. But until we let not Jesus pass by like a fleeting illusion, rather let us have him on board. Now, I'd like to just lastly and quickly meditate on a well, I apologize. First, let me say this. The Liberation Day speech of His Majesty. He says, "Ethiopia, today is a day in which, well, we stretch forth our hands to God and because of Him, I am, you know, so thankfully allowed to be here." Now, let us not rejoice. When I say rejoice, I mean rejoice in a positive way, and not rejoice in any other spirit, any other contrary wind or doctrine or philosophy, idea, whatever, that is contrary, that is not the spirit of Christ. Let us not commit those acts that are worthy of the enemy. And I won't further expound on that, but if those truthfully seeking, connect the dots and you'll figure out what's going on. We need to come together. Now, I'm going to address a second issue. I understand that there's a lot we must do in the physical. You know, with all this, the name change and the repatriation and there's, I don't have a whole lot of, like, honestly, forgive I, but I can't think of a lot of examples, but there's a lot demanded of us. We've wasted so much time, but this is hopefully words of comfort so we don't get out of control and we don't fall and buckle under the weight, because there's a lot of weight on I's shoulders, but, you know, let I, let His Majesty in and through Christ, you know, ease the pain and lighten the burden, to be exact. Now, it's too much, so let's take it a step at a time. First of all, it's too much. Some of us do not have money. I would want to change my name right now, but it takes gas, it takes time, it takes money, it takes, you know, so much. That'll come. Take it one step at a time. If we want to do everything one day, and I have that same problem, I'm not saying that I've perfected that, but I've learned that we got to take it slowly and surely. Like His Majesty advised the Ethiopians, you know, we'll get to that level of the more developed countries, but hold on, we got to, in time, be patient. Patience is the kingdom. Patient worketh faith, you know? And which leads me to the next point. Purely materialistic art would be like a tree which is expected to bear fruit without flowering, sacrificing grace and beauty for mere utility. Let us focus on planting the tree, on nurturing and growing as the tree, and flowering. Let us flower in due season. Let us not sacrifice grace, beauty for mere utility. You see, if we repatriate, if we change our names really quick, if we do all of that, That's purely materialistic. I'm not saying there's no importance to that, but let us focus on the tree and flowering. And I'm sure Jesus will kindly and generously and immediately handle all of those other things for us. Of course, we initiate, but he will execute. And so, but we gotta have him aboard first. Because even if we do fulfill those other objectives without Christ on board, you know, there's nothing you could do with that. We gotta, you know, be on his time clock, on his schedule. I know we're running short on time. I understand that, but Jah has order. He has his way of doing things, and we just gotta go with that. Now, please do not misinterpret this. I'm not saying that everything that Wendem Yadon has been saying on the name change, of course it's important. Of course we're gonna go through all of that. But I'm just trying to find words of comfort so that we kind of settle down. Okay, it's, you know, we're gonna try, but if it doesn't happen tomorrow, you know, so be it. You know, but let us go out with Christ on board. I hope I'm not confusing any, but I myself find in that kind of situation sometimes. Of course we want to do a whole bunch, but let us not get squashed under such pressure. There's beauty behind Jah, and we cannot sacrifice that. We cannot sacrifice the grace, you know. So shalom. Thank you.